And a good Saturday to everybody. My name is Jewel, and this is the tropical update for the J7409 Weather Channel. We're looking at Invest 90L. You can see it still has these thunderstorms, and it's trying to pick up a little bit of rotation. It may pick up a little speed, too, folks. Right now, it's still low, around 29 miles per hour. And it's moving slow, only at about 7 miles per hour. And the pressure in it is 29.98. Now, it's located in and around the area about 150 miles from Daytona Beach. That's what it's looking like right now. But some things could change. Now, as we come over to the National Hurricane Center, it was 50 yesterday. It's hopped up to 60% chance now, folks. Right at the moment, though, still showers and thunderstorms. They have increased a bit. Not a whole lot, but you saw those showers and thunderstorms, and one of them had some very good cloud tops to it. And this is in an association with the low pressure system about, well, they say 200 miles east of Daytona Beach, Florida. I'm saying about 153 miles, somewhere there and about. Now, the nearby buoy observations are indicating that the surface pressure has been falling close to the center of the system. However, the associated shower and thunderstorm activity remains still disorganized. As you could see, there was no closed circulation of the thunderstorms that we just looked at. Now, it's looking like, though, the environmental conditions are forecast to become a bit more favorable for development, and a tropical depression could form over the next day or so while this low just keeps meandering offshore of the Florida Peninsula. But let me tell you something, folks. It's going up. And all interest in Florida should continue to monitor the progress of this system. And here's a little red flag for you, okay? An Air Force Reserve Hurricane Hunter aircraft is scheduled to investigate this system later today if necessary. So if it looks like it is going to strengthen, they wouldn't have this aircraft on standby. And it looks like it could increase a little bit. I'm thinking, now don't get upset. No, not a great big hurricane. I don't think that's going to happen. I think it will become a tropical depression. It may stay a tropical depression, but I think there's a little teeny window it could turn into a tropical storm. Why do I say there's a little teeny window it might turn into a tropical storm? Well, this is around 11 p.m. tonight, the 24th, as you can see, the sustained winds are still 23 miles per hour. So it's going to be a tropical depression probably by tonight. But when we go up to the wind gust, it is gusting now at tropical storm force winds, 39 miles per hour. We have got to watch this system. Now, when it comes to the tracker models, as you can see right here, now, folks, I'm going to pull this down. Look, there's only one model going up this way around South Carolina and Wilmington. Don't worry about it. Don't think it's going to do that. And there's only one going up through Savannah, Georgia, and over to Macon. Don't worry about it. Don't think it's going there. But we have three that is taking it into Florida. As you can see, the three different ones right here, this is the best chance where it may come in. Now, I'm not saying Georgia might not get some little wind, South Carolina a little wind. I don't think we're going to be bothered at all right now, but who knows, folks? That's why we have to track these things. But I don't think North Carolina is going to be bothered at all. I really don't think South Carolina is. But you may get a little uptick in some wind, but nothing to worry about for Georgia and South Carolina. And more than likely, you will be getting some rain from it as the days go on. But moving across Florida, right in these areas, and it's going to bring a whole lot of rain with it, folks. As you can see, I know Florida's had a lot of rain, but you can see it's got a lot of rain stuff with it. And right in here, This is where you can see the hook. This is where the great chance for the tropical depression to form is. And like I say, it might turn into a tropical storm. I'm not betting on it right now, but I'm not saying it's out of the woods of not becoming one also. I just managed to get this from the National Hurricane Center a while ago. And this was taken at the 6Z run this morning. And it's the early cycle models. Okay, the early cycle models. Now, we always go by where most of them are, correct? Well, we got a lot of them that's down here. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 going up. And 4 of them are giving it tropical storm status at some point. Okay? The others are not. They're keeping it low. Now, in 12 hours, this is what we have to go by in 12 hours right now. Let's hop up to 24 hours right in here. The ships are saying 33 miles per hour wind. You can see this is 32, 30, 30, 25, on and on. But by the time we get to day 2 over here, the ships are saying 41 miles per hour. So see, that's going to kind of work in with what the Euro model I just showed you was showing. It had it up to 39 mile per hour winds. Well, the ships are saying 41. There's not that much difference. Now, when we come down here, this is 35 mile per hour winds. And it seems to creep on up too as we go on to 46. Now, right in here, these are the three we have to watch for tropical storm status, okay? So we'll go back to day 2, 41 miles per hour, 37 miles per hour, and 36 miles per hour. Two of them are struggling. One of them is continuing in the ship model to go out. That is the ship model. And you can see they kind of go on up together. And by the end of the week, 60 mile per hour winds, 59 mile per hour winds, 58. Don't worry about this. I'm just showing you this because we have some that say it will not. We've got to wait and see how the fronts move, folks. Now, this is the early cycle models. If we move on down just a little bit, we'll get to the late cycle models, as you can see right here. This is all they have, folks, for the late cycle models going on right now. And this is the ships, I guarantee it. No, it's not. 54 miles per hour, 45, 39. This is looking more or less like what I just showed you on the Euro model. 43, 35. Then we have this at 26. We have this at 24. So we're going to have to watch this very, very, very closely. So once again, let's go over this right quick, okay? Let's go over this very, very quickly. The showers and the thunder showers, they have increased a bit for the morning. It's still a low pressure around 200 miles east of Daytona Beach, Florida. I'm saying about 153 miles, but it doesn't matter, folks. We're going by the National Hurricane Center. Now, the buoy observations indicate the surface pressure has been falling close to the center of this system, but the shower activity is still disorganized. Now, environmental conditions are forecast to become a bit more favorable for some development, and a tropical depression could form over the next day or so. Well, I think that is going to happen, folks, without a doubt. I'm very positive at this point, unless something drastic changes, a tropical depression will form, and there is that slight chance a tropical storm may also. But you can bet on the tropical depression. That really looks 100% possible. And I'd say a tropical storm looks 50% possible. Now, it's going to just meander off the Florida Peninsula for the next day or so, but everyone, all interest in Florida, should continue to monitor the progress of this and an Air Force Reserve Hurricane Hunter aircraft is scheduled to investigate the system later today if they think necessary. And it is up now to a 60% chance for 2 days and 5 days. And everybody down around Cuba, Jamaica, Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico, and all the islands in here, looking good at the moment. You will get some sea breezes. You will be getting some rain from the upper island chain to Puerto Rico to the Dominican Republic, maybe a little over in Jamaica, going up into Cuba and the Bahamas. You will be getting some rain. You will be getting some sea breeze winds. But other than that, there's nothing coming your way at this time. Any changes, I'll be sure and update it, keep you up to date on what's going on in the tropics. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, my friends. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. And if you are into the weather, all kinds of weather, please click subscribe. The J7409 weather and symbol in the bottom right-hand corner. Click that bell and check off all to make sure you get all my latest weather updates so I can help you to know what might be headed your way and keep you safe. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.